الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام is one that say time will come where the treacherous will be regarded as trustworthy. If we look at humanity, then the pharmaceuticals and the big conglomerates have made humanity farms that will be harvested. No medicine that has been developed by them has been researched to create a cure or a remedy. Anybody who had come with an alternative were taken out. More effort has been made to develop a suppressant so this human being stays alive as long as possible and makes him dependent on these medications. And his whole life from one medicine which causes side effects to increase to a second medicine, and like that he eventually becomes a walk-in pharmacy. If you had to calculate the amount of money generated, and one of the biggest money spinners on earth is the pharmaceutical industry, where trillions are generated, and that's extorting humanity. Just on the COVID tests and the methodology of how fake it is, in February the Chinese Health Authority had released a report of all people that had recovered from illnesses connected to COVID. Those people that had recovered tested negative, then after a test they were positive again. Then a month later the Journal of Medical Virology did a test and they showed from 29 out of 610 patients in a hospital in Wuhan had 3 to 6 tests, and their results flipped between negative and positive. So that was quite questionable, it was dubious. Another example was a study done in Singapore where the tests were carried out almost daily on 18 patients. And a majority of these patients tested from positive to negative to positive. Sometimes in a single patient, it switched 5 times. The president of the Chinese Academy of Medical Sciences, he conceded in February already that time that these PCR tests were only 30 to 50% accurate. And a letter was sent to the World Health Organization team, and their letter, the summary was that the kits used in generating results were not accurate. In another journal, they say the rate of 20% was assumed. So, and if you've seen it also, somebody who's got all the symptoms, and that's here, we've heard of people, we've spoken to people who've got all the symptoms, but they test negative. Somebody's got no symptoms, and they test positive. So they say an accuracy rate of 50%. And if we had to go by other statistics in a worst case scenario of 22%, we call it false positives. Then if 9 million people were tested, and if we go on that ratio worldwide on a viral infection, 2 million people will be on false positives, or vice versa. If we had to go on the 50%, then 4.5 million. So the question again, in a CDC diagnostic file, they state detection of viral RNA may not indicate the presence of infectious virus or that of COVID-19 is a causative agent for clinical symptoms. The test cannot rule out diseases caused by other bacterial or viral pathogens. So a person might test positive but he has other viruses. The FDA states they do not rule out bacterial infection or co-infection with other viruses. The agent detected may not be a definite cause of COVID. And we're talking of COVID-19. If we look at the companies that manufacture and produce the manuals and the instructions, if we go into the PCR tests, then they clearly state it's not intended for a diagnostic test. And let's go one of the companies, Light Mix Modular Assays, which is distributed by Roche, and they state, these are the words verbatim, these assays are not intended for use as an aid in the diagnosis of coronavirus infection. It is for research use only, not for use in diagnostic procedures. So there's a big question mark just on the methodology. Then secondly, another aspect is professional medical training and ethics dictate that for a person to be diagnosed with an infection, he should have lab evidence as well. So you have lab evidence and physical symptoms to support the diagnosis. Somebody who is tested positive for HIV may not have AIDS. Likewise, somebody who's got a test for SARS-CoV-2 may not have COVID-19. So these were the accepted professional standards in the diagnosis used in the medical practice. Professionals that were licensed went by this. Now we have a change in policy where you cannot distinguish between people who have COVID-19 or something else. So we will have an excessive number of people who are probable or suspected cases. And according to some data, around 70 to 80% of hospital admissions were not lab confirmed. And if we go by the statistics which has been mentioned previously of 50% of accuracy on the tests, then likelihood, if we had to combine both, we would say probably the data out there is 10 to 20% accurate. Then go into the death rate, which we won't get into now, but how much is, and discussed previously, how much is accurately diagnosed as COVID and the cause of death. And based on these results, if we do the false positives and the PCR tests and the machine which has not been required, then the generally accepted medical standard for a lab test accuracy is 95% and above. We working on 70 to 80 if we discrete, otherwise 50 or even less, 10 to 20%. And then if we look at the nucleic fragments and other entities and discovering remnants of another infection or prior infection, then that puts the statistics completely off. Then we get the malpractice where the idea is to capitalize on this opportunity. So Big Pharma, Remdesivir, which is now the proven remedy. So they're saying that a single treatment of Remdesivir will bring around $2,500 per patient, and hydroxychloroquine will bring literally nothing. So there's a big cover up, there's a big propaganda. These are the treacherous people which have been believed and the world is going by. Their products have been authenticated and verified internationally, but in reality, there's a plan. What would be the motive, somebody would ask? Trillions and trillions of euros. For money, they would commit murder, they would wipe out nations, they would kill people, they would become treacherous for monetary gain. Does industry, do they have the means and the resources to do that? Yes. Because we have people who have from the inside turned, and their testimonies John Weirapan, the former CEO of Eli Lilly and Company in Sweden. Then we've got other medical major journals, former editors, Marsha Angel, etc., etc. Their testimonies, and they were part of Lancet, and their testimonies prove that this has been done. If you want to know where else, then if you look at the corruption of the doctors in the pharmaceutical industry, Scott Rubin falsified data concerning the efficiency of the antidepressant effects, and that's been documented. Then if we look at the story of Kuwaiti babies torn from their incubator and thrown to the ground by Iraqi soldiers, this was done in propaganda to allow America to intervene in the 1990 Iraq war, where George Bush Sr. used this statement in his inflammatory speeches, and he said that this is happening, but we all know it was a lie. And they didn't want any support to Saddam Hussein, and they wanted the world to back them up for the invasion. The PR firm Hill and Knowlton was behind this, also helped now currently the WHO spread the rumor of the harms of the pandemic, and they were behind this as well. So hydroxychloroquine, which is cheap, which is effective, they've even created a report which was published on May 22nd, The Lancet, and they were fake figures and test trials. So according to this report, 96,032 patients were hospitalized, and tests from 671 hospitals worldwide were done. And their results show that hydroxychloroquine does not benefit but harms more. So this is to promote Big Pharma and their remedies. So if we look at the article, eventually they retracted it. And then a tiny US company was blamed for it. But even this company here, it included a science fiction writer and other people that were expert in spreading and making up flawed data. Then if we look at Anthony Fauci, who's America's top infectious disease expert, does it say the treacherous people are regarded as trustworthy? And he was in the forefront of smearing the hydroxychloroquine remedy. He's been head of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases. He was in the time of the Reagan administration. He's a mouthpiece of Big Pharma. And he was promoting remdesivir. And he's saying it's a wonder drug, which is obviously produced by Gilead Sciences Incorporated, a multi-billion-dollar biopharmaceutical company, which develop many cures, and they have very strong ties with the US government. The same company in 1999 developed Tamiflu, which is a treatment for influenza and bird flu. But you must remember, this company was headed by Donald Rumsfeld, 1997 to 2001, who joined George W. Bush administration, and from 2001 to 2006, he was the Secretary of Defense. He was also responsible for the illegal invasion and criminal wars in Afghanistan, 001, and Iraq, 003. So he's been in charge of senior positions in government. He's been part of Big Pharma. The Rumsfeld has been part of this year. Fauci has been part of this whole thing. And in 2008, Fauci was granted a Presidential Medal of Freedom by George W. Bush. What for? For his determined and aggressive efforts to help others live longer and healthier lives. A person, as Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, those that are treacherous will be honored and made trustworthy. Then now recently he was the advisor, the expert advisor if we can say, for Trump. And this resulted in the complete shutdown of the greatest economic engine in world history. Otherwise, from 2005, chloroquine was an effective inhibitor for coronaviruses. If we go back in time and we find the similarities, then that time it was a cure for SARS, for the virus. In an official publication in the Virology Journal, which was the National Institute of Health, and at that time they stated chloroquine is a potent inhibitor of SARS coronavirus infection and spread. It has a strong antiviral effect. So all the data, which was of course prepared by Fauci, and they knew it for the last 15 years. And it was a treatment and is a treatment for the current virus. There was a doctor, Dr. Stoyan Eklaksov, who called the WHO a criminal medical organization for creating worldwide fear and chaos without providing objectively verifiable proof. So a big scam, the treacherous are being believed. Likewise, Bill Gates, who advocates vaccinations in Africa, advocates population reduction, and the World Economic Forum, the Rockefeller, the Rothschild, the Morgans, and these big, big conglomerates have their agendas in mind. But we should remember, as people of Iman, innahum yakiduna kayda wa akidu kayda. The people of Iman should do what they should be doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do what he has to do. We should not get caught in this propaganda. When the command of Allah is to go to the masjid, let us fulfill the command of Allah. When the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes, the people of Iman are not lax and relaxed, but they are in the forefront to see that they obey what Allah and His Rasul have commanded, and they don't get hoodwinked by the external propaganda and information relayed by the people of Batil. The amal for today, مَمْ مَسَحَ عَلَى رَأْسِي يَتِيمٍ. Whoever spreads his hand over the head of an orphan with the intention only for Allah's sake, for every hair he will get a reward. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنَ إِلَىٰ يَتِيمٍ. Whoever does good to an orphan, كُنْتُ أَنَا وَهُوَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ كَهَاتَيْنِ. Nabi alayhi salam said we would be close together, and he joined his two fingers. A sahabi came and he said, my heart is hard. Nabi alayhi salam said, do you want your heart to be softened and your needs to be fulfilled? إِمْسَحْ رَأْسَ الْيَتِيمِ. Wipe your hands on the orphan. إِرْحَمْ. And have mercy on the orphans. وَأَطْعِمِ الْمِسْكِينِ. And feed the people that are needy. And feed them, the orphans, some your food. And look after them well. يَلِنْ قَلْبُكْ وَتُدْرِكْ حَاجَتَكْ. Your heart will become soft and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fulfill your needs. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq of making amal. وآخر دعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين.